I'm here with Kristopher Belman, director of More Than a Game, and I'm asking him about his take on friendship in the film.
Yeah, you know, at the end of the day, I think the film is really about friendship and dreams. And one of the questions I get asked the most is just about if these boys are still close. Are they still friends? You know, there's five boys in the film, and they're best friends. And everyone wonders, now that LeBron's in the NBA, if they're still friends. And I'm always so pleased to answer that they're closer now than they were even back then. You know, these boys, a lot of them have families now, they have kids, and they're growing even closer in each other's lives, you know. I remember last year, every year Coach Drew has a Christmas party, and I remember I went over to his house last Christmas, and, you know, he welcomes me to his home, and he says, hey, the kids are in the basement. And I'm thinking, kids, these guys are like, you know, 6'7", 6'8", but I go in the basement, and the five guys are all there. You know, it's Christmas Eve, and, you know, that's a kind of a night you spend with your family, and that's what these boys did. They were downstairs, they were playing cards with each other. They were all, you know, they were giving LeBron a hard time because he didn't play well that night. And, you know, that's the kind of thing only your best friends can do. You know what I mean? Like LeBron, you know, he didn't shoot well that night. Those guys are close enough to him that they can kind of call him out on a little bit and joke about it. That kind of thing speaks to their friendships.
Can you tell me a bit about what the team meant to LeBron growing up? In the film, you discuss kind of it was more than a family to him, really.
Yeah. Well, you know, I think given the circumstances that LeBron grew up in, you know, not really having a stable home. You know, it was just him and his mom, and they kind of moved from place to place, staying with friends and things like that. I think the game of basketball and that team gave him a sense of stability and of confidence. In every other area he had in life, he didn't have confidence and he didn't have stability. And those boys became his family, and that court and what they were able to do together, that gave him a sense of confidence that he didn't really have anywhere else. And I think that just gave him kind of an anchor and a foundation to build upon. You know, and everything he's doing now in the NBA and on and off the court, it's all because of what he went through as a kid and those friends and family that he found in those boys and in that team.
You followed LeBron and his teammates during his senior year at high school. Can you tell me a bit about how crazy it was in terms of media coverage? He became a national figure during high school.
It was his senior year. I mean, it was nuts. It was crazy because, you know, the team hired security guards. There are security guards to keep people away, you know. We'd go into the locker room at halftime, and there would be ESPN cameras and Fox Sports cameras, and they were kind of being held back. And those same security guards were like grabbing me and pulling me in the locker room because I was fortunate enough to be a part of this journey. And you know, that gave me kind of a sense of pressure and obligation. I had to make sure that I took this project serious and made the best film I could. But it was like a rock and roll tour. I mean, they were traveling the country, and they were, you know, we'd pull up on a bus in Philadelphia, and there'd be grown men that had driven 6 hours away to be there when the bus arrived so that they could try and get his autograph. I mean, it really was like a rock and roll tour.
It's quite rare for a player to be written up on the cover of Sports Illustrated while still at high school.
Yeah. I mean, that's kind of unprecedented in a way. I mean, you know, I think it happens once in a while, but, you know, it's certainly few and far between when it does. So I think that was the start of it all in a lot of ways. I think a lot of people describe it as kind of pre-Sports Illustrated, post-Sports Illustrated. After that cover of SI, it was, the media was everywhere, you know, and everything he did was kind of scrutinized. And I think it certainly, you know, as the film shows, it started to go to their heads, and I think it ended up being kind of the downfall of the hero. But it was also one of the most important lessons that all those boys learned, including LeBron, when they lost that game their junior year, which you see in the film. I think that's just as big a reason he's in the NBA as anything else. You know, you have to go through those things and learn from your mistakes, and that was certainly a chance for them to do that.
Kristopher Belman, thanks very much.
Hey, thanks for having me.